Hello everybody, welcome back to our channel. Hope you all are fine. So today in this video, we are going to study about measurements in chemistry. Basically, chemistry is a quantitative science because it describes nature using quantities which are measurable. Before proceeding to the teaching part, let's have a look at the learning outcomes. So in this video, I'm going to explain about significant figures in measurements, measured numbers and exact numbers, experimental errors, accuracy and precision, and finally percentage errors. Let's begin our lesson. You may be already familiar with some of these quantities that are frequently used in chemistry, such as length, time, mass and force. All these quantities are measured using measuring instruments in a prescribed way to assign values. For instance, to determine the length of an object, we use meter stick. Let's proceed with the significant figures in measurements. Significant figures in measurements include known digit plus one estimated digit. The measurements usually inherent uncertainty or experimental errors. Always remember that as the number of significant figures increases, the more certain the measurement. In order to understand better, let's have a look at an example. So in this example, we are measuring the length of a pencil using a ruler. As you can see in the diagram, the exact answer is 7 cm. But as we know, significant measurement includes known and estimated digit. So our estimated value is 0.05 cm, which is in between 0.04 and 0.06 cm. This makes the final answer 7.05 cm, which is the sum of 7.00 cm and 0.05 cm. Next, we are going to learn how to write a measurement. According to IUPAC system, a measurement should be recorded as number space followed by unit. Here is an example on how to record the volume of burette 40.2 milliliters. The answer is 40.2 space ml. Next, measured and exact numbers. Measured numbers are the actual estimated reading that has been taken out from displaced meters, detectors of instruments, graduated equipments such as burette and pipette, or mathematical calculations, for example, average and standard deviation. Exact numbers are called exact values because they are measured in complete units, for example, 60 seconds in a minute, 7 days in a week, and many more. Next, we are going to learn about types of experimental errors. In scientific measurements, it is common to encounter experimental errors. Normally, there are two types of errors, which are systematic error and random error. Systematic error is an error that is introduced by inaccuracy, as of observation or measurement. The examples of causes of systematic errors are instruments that are not properly calibrated, carelessness in preparing a reagent, and also imperfections of instruments. Systematic errors can be easily reduced by proper calibration, usage of more sensitive instruments, and also committed to strict preparation procedures. Random errors in experimental measurements are caused by unknown or unpredictable changes in environmental condition or measuring instrument. Examples of causes of random errors are human error due to carelessness, or results taken at different temperature. Random errors can be improved by controlling environmental factors and taking average readings. Next, let's learn about accuracy and precision. Accuracy and precision are not the same thing, although they are related. Accuracy is the degree of closeness of measurement to the correct value. In other words, it is the agreement of a measurement with the accepted value of the quantity. While precision is the degree of closeness of measurement to other measurement of the same thing. In other words, the degree of reproducibility. A commonly used way of measuring precision is by calculating standard deviation using this formula below. In this formula, the n represents the number of measurements, x represents each individual measurement, and x average is the mean of all measurements. Always remember that lower the standard deviation, higher the precision. In this diagram, the bull's eye of target represents accuracy and precision. In the first diagram, the results are not accurate and less precise. In the second diagram, the results are accurate but still less precise. In the third diagram, the results are not accurate but highly precise. And finally, in the last diagram, the results are accurate and also highly precise. Next is percentage error. The experimental error in measurement is determined by the percentage of errors. The formula that we need to use in order to find percentage error is experimental value minus with literature value divided by literature value and finally multiply by 100. Let's try an example question. In this question, a student measured the density of a substance as 5.2 gram per milliliter. What is the percentage error if the accepted value of density is 5.0 gram per milliliter? So first, we need to solve this question by writing down the formula. So in this case, the experimental value is 5.2 gram per milliliter and the literature value is the accepted value, which is 5.0 gram per milliliter. So when we solve the equation, we will get the final answer 4%. Well, we have reached the end part of this video. Hope you all understand today's lesson. If you have any question, feel free to ask by commenting. And don't forget to subscribe our channel for more videos. Have a great day. See you all in the next video. Bye.